Andy, do you want to talk a bit about the HMO proposition that Zephyr offer? Because that's something that we're pretty hot on.
Yeah, absolutely, Tim. I was just gonna pick up on something Liz said there as well, because we, as you know, we run the DPS, the Deposit Protection Scheme. And one of the things that we've seen within that model is that there's been some sort of urban migration. So people are moving out of city centres to suburban areas, or from suburbia out into the rural market. So, you know, kind of
space race, we call it. Yeah,
the space race. Exactly right. And, you know, you're seeing that you know, it's an opportunity for landlords to think, rethink their portfolio, maybe get into the higher yielding market. And of course, what we're also seeing is landlords, as this is happening, we're seeing landlords think about, you know, is there more profitability potentially in HMOs, which kind of leads into the question you've asked. I mean, for Zephyr, we're one of many lenders that play in the HMO space. Our policy is pretty flexible, actually. We will go up to 6 bedrooms on one in one home let by 6 individuals, but we'll do professional tenants, we'll do DSS tenants, we'll do student lets, locks on doors, no locks on doors. A lot of lenders don't like locks on doors. We're fine with that. Communal space, no communal space, kitchens, bathrooms in rooms. There's a lot of flexibility around our policy on HMO. So I think it's, you know, it's a great opportunity to engage with brokers and obviously with you know, people like Liz that run bigger organisations, that we can get through the network and talk about that proposition.
I think it's a real opportunity for brokers to get into, but I think they also need to spend a bit of time making sure they understand the market. You know, Andy mentioned locks on doors, for example. Not every lender does that, you know, and it's not a piece of criteria you can search on any of the criteria searching very, very easily. So you could find yourself, if you don't understand that market, you know, picking a lender, sending a surveyor out, and then having that property declined on something as small as that piece of criteria. I think also understanding the licensing rules is something that's key for brokers to look at. You know, if it's a property that's got, you know, 5 unconnected tenants from 2 or more households, that's a mandatory requirement to have a license. So that's quite simple and straightforward to understand. But actually, local authorities can determine properties that have got less numbers of people in household scale, so maybe 3 people sharing, as a HMO and still require a license. And you can't Google that. You can't find that out. You've got to phone up the local authority. So advisors need to be able to coach their clients to phone up the local authority, find out if a license is needed for that specific property, and then bring that back to their researching to find the lenders who will accept licensed HMOs rather than unlicensed multi-let, which is quite a different proposition in terms of the criteria out there.